All right, folks. We're now at the David Brilley Athletic Center here at Mohawk, and we're about to watch the gold medal game of the OCAA Women's Championship game. It's a head-to-head matchup at of Algonquin versus our Mohawk Mountaineers.
All right here, folks. For Algonquin, it's been 18 games in 3 years. They've been tested, but they've been champs for the last three and unbeaten this season. Five times the previous champion they have been, and they're looking to defend their title here tonight. Two victories this weekend by 30 points and 27. They've dominated the field. It's whether or not Mohawk can top them. They're going for their first title in 22 years. They haven't won since 1991. They're a six-time champion and looking to take home gold at home. They scraped by Durham and dominated Humber last night, taking a second half serve. It's going to come down to who has more composure and who can play in a big-time game. This place is going to get loud and ruckus at the David Brilley.
And sorry, folks, at home, I just forgot to introduce myself. I'm Elvin Drent, sitting along here with Jake Parkhill, and we'll be your commentators for tonight here at the David Brilley Athletic Center. And we're just moments away from tip-off. Once again, it's the Mohawk Mountaineers versus Algonquin College.
You can cut the tension with a knife.
Absolutely, this arena
George
is nearly
Rackus,
sold out.
Rackus about to throw up the ball.
Tip off is just on the way, and the tip off is won by Algonquin.
Oh, we have an illegal tip. So what happened there was
and we'll try that again.
So what happened there was caught there. It wasn't a very good tip, so they're going to re-tip it.
And Algonquin wins the tip off. As we see Cupid running up the court, passing it. And their first shot attempt is no good, but they're able to recover with the rebound as Cupid picks up the slack and throws the ball in the basket for 2 points. Here we see Mohawk uncontested as they bring up the ball. 9 minutes and 36 seconds into the first quarter, folks. She's looking around. Finds Abella. Abella uses the screen nicely. And she's fouled.
Jalen Arbor gonna go to the line for two. Open it up there, a foul on the side.
Caitlin Arbor, 5'9 from Hamilton, guard/forward. Remember, folks, this is the gold medal game, so everything is on the line for these girls. She'll shoot two. The first one is no good. She'll try her luck at a second shot. As Algonquin leads the game so far, 2-0 Mohawk. And that second shot is no good. Algonquin remains in the lead. As that pass is nearly tipped off, that shot's no good. As Abella comes racing up the court, looking around for her options, looking for something. Dribbles along the perimeter. Finds Brown. Brown gets called for the travel. Her feet left the ground, but she didn't release the ball, so that will be a travel.
Came back down. The ball was stuffed back into her, and it's a travel on FIBA to held ball in Federation.
So what on the stat sheet, would that count as a block or a...
Oh, it's a turnover.
Turnover,
and,
exactly.
Yeah, it's a turnover against Mohawk there.
And Algonquin is inbounding the ball there. You see Coach Duffy for Mohawk speaking to his players from across the court. And the referees are just having a discussion. Not too sure what's going on.
They're resetting the shot clock to 18, so they got two.
There you have it.
Two to get it over.
Shot clock reset as Cupid figures out what she's going to do. Looks for someone. The pick is, she almost picks off the pass. Mohawk with that intensive D. Gathering up that energy from the crowd out here.
Carissa Brown going to get called for hack for the hack there, and front court drawn to Algonquin.
Algonquin already has two team fouls as they find Cupid at the perimeter. She drives, takes her goal, Carissa snatches the ball away from her, saying, give me that rock, as Abella brings up the ball back to Brown. They find, she can't find the hoop.
Lacey Walters just experiencing some first quarter jitters.
Tough shot to no avail, as Brown grabs the rebound and gives it to Abella. Abella calling for something. Looking for that screen, looking for that cutter. She can't find the hoop. Rebounded by the Thunder, Algonquin Thunder. She comes racing up the court. Nice little hop step. She gets that beautiful basket to go in. Number 24.
Mohawk here needs to calm down, and they need to calm down with a bucket. And we got a foul here up against Algonquin.
You're absolutely right. Mohawk doesn't have the best start so far. We're unable to score.
Excuse me there, that's going to be a foul on Carissa Brown, and that's her second early.
A couple substitutions made. Yeah. Carissa Brown's sisters will be exchanging.
So Carissa has two fouls in the first 2 minutes and 15 seconds.
Keep in mind, she is an aggressive player, so those kind of things are going to happen during this game, but let's make sure that we can stay level-headed and walk away with the gold here, folks. Cupid traveled. A lot of traveling going on in this tournament.
Now she just shifted her feet there, and it's one of those things that you got called for a couple times in the semifinal.
The Thunder looking to make a couple of exchanges. Cupid gets exchanged for Felicia Mazzaroli after that turnover that she committed. Mohawk inbounds the ball. Abella being heavily guarded by Mazzaroli.
Yeah, I'm definitely not gonna sit the rest of this game.
Now you see Brown threw that ball up and gets fouled. That's a hard foul, as well as a tough shot.
Yeah, that's gonna be a foul there, and Lindsay Whitaker just blocking in, and two shots now for Karina Brown.
My camera's not zooming in.
So she'll shoot two. First one, makes it. We hear the fans giving that motivation. Second attempt is good. She scores the, Karina Brown scores the first 2 points for Mohawk with 7 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the first quarter.
Natalie Fisher going to check into the game here for Mohawk as they pick up on a 1-3-1.
She nearly trips and falls. She does fall.
And
she gets called for the travel, folks. She gets called for the travel. That Mohawk pressure is just too much, especially Mohawk has that home court advantage.
Karina Brown there caused the travel. With her defensive pressure there, she got her hand on the ball and forced her down.
Allison DiLorenzi pops it. No bueno. Algonquin moves the ball around. As you see her back her down and spin around. That shot nearly drops in, but not that time. As Mohawk rushes up the court. Now you have Abella guarded tightly. She spins off her, loses her. She gets fouled. Nearly traveled, but gets fouled. She'll shoot two.
Yeah, Mazzaroli bumped her off, and that caused the travel there. And she'll go to the line for two shots as Cupid comes back into the game.
That's Jen Abella shooting two.
And a quick exchange there with Cupid as they're subbing in and out.
Excuse me, she won't be shooting two, but Mohawk does gain possession.
We got two shots coming up here as Natalie Fisher there got fouled. As Claire Abbott picks up her first.
She'll be shooting at the line as Algonquin makes an exchange, player 8 for player 9.
Three and a half gone by here. Algonquin with a 4-2 lead. Mohawk still without a field goal. They've scored both their points at the free throw line.
I have faith in the Mohawk team. They're just off to a slow start, but they're just warming up. 6 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in the first quarter here at the OCAA gold medal game. As you can see, the crowd is in a frenzy, anticipating for Mohawk to score their next basket and get back into this game. Jenna Bella passes at the perimeter. She looks back. Abella looking to share the ball. Karina shares it back. They move around. Good passing going on. Keep in mind the shot clock is ticking down. She stops and pops. She doesn't get it that time, but the shot clock will be reset. That shot is rolls and walks along the top of the backboard.
Stayed along the top and didn't hit either the shot clock or the sanction there.
Cuba's back in the game, and she just picked up an assist right there. Number 9 of the Thunder, Lauren Carey, just scores. Abella with a nice handle. She drives, looks to share the ball. She thought about the three. She did shoot the three, but she had that hand in her face, so she didn't make it. Driving. Incredible.
And one.
Incredible and one play right there. I had no idea that was going to go in.
That's going to be on Karina Brown. And she picks up her first. So the Brown sisters in a bit of foul trouble in the first 5 minutes. So as Carissa is already on the bench with two.
She'll try and make that a three-point play, hopefully.
Yeah, actually, the one thing is Mohawk's got to get in here.
Let's see if she can make that into a three-point play.
The score the players there were outside the three-point arc there. It would have been just a free throw hitter.
She tries her luck at a three to no luck there. Mohawk with a nice rebound. They bring it up the court. Heavy defense by Algonquin. They force you see the Mohawk will gain possession. Algonquin will gain possession as
that goes a foul. That goes against Hermack there, and
Hermack jumped over the back of the Algonquin player.
By the way, now the next 4 minutes and 55 seconds, both teams are in the bonus. That was the fourth team foul against Mohawk. Algonquin already with four.
Simpson heavily, Cupid heavily guarded. She passes the ball, and that's an air ball way off the mark as it's going to be Mohawk possession.
Lauren Carey just had the ball bounced off her foot and out of bounds.
Score is 8-3 for Algonquin. Super exciting game here. Glad to be a part of it. As you see them rotating the ball around the perimeter, she stops and pops. That shot's no good. And Lacey Walters is out rebounded by Cupid over there. And a couple players falling. She gives the ball. And 21, Jessica Basquin.
Kevin Duffy needs a timeout here.
Duffy definitely needs a timeout. Needs to slow down the momentum of the Thunder out here. They move the ball around. Can she do it? Not that time.
This is what Algonquin does. They're going to challenge her shots and then work in transition. That's how they won their first two games, and they did it by 30 each time.
Good ball rotation. She spins around. Gets called for a charge.
That's going to go against Sandra Basco there. The fifth-year senior out of Ottawa. And we have a timeout. And Kevin Duffy wants to talk it over.
Timeout.
Mohawk, 6 minutes into the game here, doesn't have a field goal yet. And that's the one thing they need to calm down. And the one thing to calm that will calm a team down is a quick basket. They've gotten it inside to Lacey Walters, but she's been strong on her three shot attempts so far. And the Brown sisters, the game's being called tight, but the Brown sisters are out of the game right now because of foul trouble. Karina has one, Carissa has two. And when you take out your most aggressive defenders there, that's going to make it tough here. Well, the Brown sisters were in the game. It was 4-3. It's now 6-0 with them out of the game. For Algonquin, they are currently running transition, which is what they want to do here. They're picking up on Mohawk mistakes and getting out and running. If they can do that and get the easy baskets here, it's going to be a long game for the Mountaineers. And it's pretty simple here. Mohawk needs to get back out and stop them in transition or take better shots and get back quickly. And better shots doesn't necessarily mean farther shots to get back quickly. You can be in the post and get back, but you got to hustle it up. Knocking the ball out of bounds is just as good as getting a turnover.
Mohawk hoping to change the pace of the game here with this possession here. Ball is thrown out of bounds by Mohawk. Good pressure by Algonquin. Keep in mind, folks, that Algonquin had a perfect regular season record, 16-0, and they finished first in their division, the Eastern Division. As you see, Cupid throw the ball to the perimeter. They move the ball to the post, back to the perimeter. Cupid, that shot's good.
That's a trifecta there by Cupid. They're threatening to take Mohawk right out of this game right now. They're up 10 early.
Absolutely. But that defense is being executed well by Algonquin. She's double teamed. Ball stripped away.
They're gonna slow it down here.
Algonquin showing Mohawk why they're number one. And she gets called for the travel as she loses her footing there. And interesting fact here about Algonquin, according to my notes, it says that every game that they won was by double digits. So not only do they win, they dominate.
You know, that is a pretty impressive stat there when you look over the course of the season. They're 18-0 heading into tonight's contest. And all of them by double digits, including the last two.
Not too sure what's in that Algonquin water, but the coach seems to be doing a good job as well as the players. And there you have Mohawk's Hermack scoring that field goal, bringing some more motivation to the crowd here over in Mohawk.
That's Mohawk's first field goal, and it came over 7 minutes into the game here. So now let's see if they can relax a little bit and try to cut the deficit.
Sandra Bosco, you just saw her score for Algonquin on that last play. As Hermack sends it over the perimeter, risky pass. Abella looking for a shot option. She finds one, unable to make it drop as Cupid.
The held ball, Mohawk's gonna keep it now on the end line there. As Kim Cupid got in there.
For her size, she's pretty tough. Mohawk unable to connect again. As you see Algonquin, she goes all the way, she's off to the races, and she makes it.
Out in transition goes Jessica Basquin.
Basquin standing at 6'1".
It's a 12-point Algonquin lead right now.
Good ball rotation by Mohawk. Abella drives, she shares the ball back to her sister, and then she passes back to her sister. Algonquin defense seems to be working.
And a quick foul there on Rochelle Abella there. Stopped that pass from coming, and it's going to be two shots going the other way now.
As Algonquin on quite the run so far this first quarter. We have about 1 minute and 32 seconds remaining.
So just something to watch here. Karina Brown's checked back into the game with one foul here. So we'll see how she does and how long she can stay in. Coach bought her some time on the bench now, but needs her in now.
Jessica Basquin, 6'1 forward out of Ottawa, Ontario, is unable to connect on that first try. Her second try, will she make it? She didn't make it.
Well, we got a foul against Basquin, and Jenna Bella will be shooting two down on the other end.
OCAA 2014 gold medal games, folks. It's off to a good start for Algonquin so far.
Right now, Mohawk's cold from the field, so they got to take advantage of the free throw line. They can stay in this game if they get their free throws here, and although this is the first trip to the line in about 4 minutes here, if they can hit their free throws throughout the game here, it's just as good as a field goal.
That ball gets lost in transition, but picked up by Algonquin. Algonquin in transition, she goes for the scoop layup and is unable to make it as Mohawk picks up the slack and turns up the heat. She tries her luck. That shot is a bit off as the ball will remain in Mohawk possession.
Before this possession here, Mohawk won the last two-pack 1-0. And this is the thing here. You can win 3-2. You can win 6-4 over two three-pack possessions here, but you got to keep making ground here. It's 11 points, and there's 31 minutes to go in this game. Plenty of time.
Absolutely. Abella drives hard. Fouled by Cupid on Algonquin. She'll shoot two. Under 1 minute left in the game. Algonquin leads by almost over 10 points.
I'll have to double check here, but I think that's Cupid's second foul. I think she picked one up early in the contest as well, too. And she's staying into the game right now.
They might have to figure out an answer to this problem that they're having real quickly.
Well, the game has been called tightly. We're on five fouls each, and 10 fouls total. 8 of them came in the first 4 minutes of the game, so it's really cleaned up over the last 5.
Absolutely. It's Algonquin. Looks to make use of the clock. They slow it right down. They look around for their options, pass it along the perimeter. She thought about it. Cupid shares the ball to the post. Good defense by Mohawk. Ball nearly kicked away. Algonquin, 1 second left, didn't make it.
That's some good defense there by Mohawk.
Great defense there by Mohawk.
They had a shot, but it was a bad look, and so they elected not to take it, and as a result, it's a shot clock violation.
Abella shares it to the perimeter. She's back at the perimeter with the ball, feeds in the post, and Algonquin will get called.
That's going to be on Sierra Churchill and sent Lacey Walters to the line there. Two-shot penalty as a hold there on Walters.
Lacey Walters, a second-year player, standing at 6'3 out of Kingsville, Ontario. She'll shoot two.
I didn't quite see it. I was looking on the ball here, so the hold must have been before she received the pass.
She'll shoot a second one. The first one wasn't too good, but she might be able to make it up. The second one is good. Now you see the half-court trap being executed by Mohawk. Good teamwork by Abella. That defense is superb as she gets the ball.
Jenna Bella popped up. She was on her knees and in one dribble, she was on her feet.
And that last shot was no good by Mohawk as we close off the first quarter, 17-8, Algonquin. Algonquin really applying the pressure here. Algonquin's pressure has been relentless defensively and offensively, as you can see that.
Well, Algonquin, they play in the transition game. And what they do is they're going to capitalize on a Mohawk mistake, whether that's a missed shot or whether that's an intercepted pass or other type of turnover. So they're looking to run and get out on the ball, and that's a big key there for Algonquin. So far they've done it here. They have other 17 points. I'm going to say about 8 or 10 of them now have come in transition, and that's the lead right there. So it's been a good half for Algonquin. For Mohawk here, they just need to settle down a little bit. I've been saying that now, but it really is true. They're a little tense right now on offense, and the shots that they're getting are good looks, but they're either too hard or too soft here. So when they settle down, they'll get a little better going here. I believe they only have one or two field goals. Actually, I'm certain they might only have one. They might have a second.
All right, so we're going to take a look at some highlights from the first quarter here. As you can see, Algonquin passing the ball nicely. Cupid gets that shot to go. And the ball is stripped away by Brown. Then you can see Ermac with that nice field goal.
Yeah, so Mohawk here, they need to come out and attack in this quarter here. It's 17-8 right now, so it's only 9 points. At the very worst case scenario for Mohawk, they want to keep it at 9. If it gets to 10 or more, it's going to be real tough in that second half to come back from. You have 30 minutes, cut it down to 5. You don't have to get it all back right now. Get a chunk of it back and then work towards it in the third quarter and even more of it in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. As we're back here at the David Brilley Athletic Center, second quarter of the OCAA Women's Championship gold medal game. Algonquin versus Mohawk.
Liveliest crowd in the tournament so far.
The crowd yelling defense, defense. As that spin move and shot is unsuccessful, but she gets a trip to the line.
Portia Hewitt's going to get dinged for the foul there and send Sandra Bosco to the line there. Just kind of hacked in on the arm.
Absolutely. Sandra Bosco. That shot was good. Bringing the lead to 19. Tough defense by Algonquin.
And a quick foul there on Cupid. And she's going to come out of the game right now in favor of Mazrul and Rada. That's a big foul against Cupid there, too. Really kind of the life force of Algonquin. Now going to sit on the bench probably for the majority of the quarter.
She drives hard to the rim. Brown, three-pointer's no good. Rebounded by Algonquin. Algonquin being pressed. Good defense by Mohawk. They move the ball around. Highly contested shot is no good by Algonquin. Mohawk wins the ball off the court. Abella shares the ball at the perimeter. She shares it back. Sends it back. Looking around. Shot clock winding down. Plenty of time left. She thought about it. Looking for an option. She gets blocked. That shot, you know, she had 5 seconds to shoot. I feel like that shot was a bit rushed, but.
Well, it wasn't a bad look there. Just she shot it a little, it came off a little low and blocked out of bounds there.
That was just good defense on Algonquin's part. 5 seconds left on the shot clock.
Everyone came off of that whistle for Mohawk except for Karina Brown.
Nice high-flying rebound by the Algonquin player. The ball is stripped away nearly. They're fighting for that ball. You can really tell both teams want that gold medal at the end of the night.
And last touch there was by Steph Hermack going out of bounds here. Mohawk's really stepped up the defensive intensity this quarter.
Here you see good ball rotation. She gets fouled. And
that's going to be Brown's second.
Brown has to watch out.
Excuse me, Karina Brown second, and in comes Carissa, who also has two. And she picked up two in the first 2 minutes. So she's going to try to buy some time here with 8:32 left to go in the half.
That first foul shot is good by Mazarol. Second shot is good as well. 8 minutes and 32 seconds. Algonquin has 22 and Mohawk has 8 in this gold medal game. Algonquin looking to make some substitutions as they steal the ball. She's off to the races, folks. That's too easy. But she scores.
That's a simple Mohawk mistake there, and it's transition points for Algonquin.
Mohawk just unable to find the back of the bottom of the net here, folks.
Well, I tell you, if I didn't know any better, I would swear there's a piece of saran wrap on the top of that net there.
Ball's hit just about every part of the rim, and it can't go in for Mohawk right now.
I agree, as Mazurah will try her luck at a three. And Algonquin picks up the mess and puts it back in the rim.
We got a timeout, Mohawk.
Here you see Mohawk regrouping and regathering as Coach Duffy tries to come up with a plan to fix this problem that they're having.
It's 25-8 right now, and it's an 8-0 run over the first 2 minutes, 10 seconds of the quarter here. But Duffy here needs to stop the bleeding, and he's got to tell them to make smart passes, wait for the right shot to come. And if you're shooting it with 1 second left, it goes in. It's the same as if you shot with 20 seconds left.
Absolutely, and here's Algonquin.
Yeah. And John McGinnis here in his tribute, just he's got to tell them, just keep doing what you're doing. Play hard, look for the mistake, and run in transition here. I mean, there's a reason why they're three-time defending OCAA champs. It's because they're good out in transition, and they capitalize on your mistakes. I mean, the one thing is they don't grant automatic berths into the national championship unless you're the host team. And Algonquin is not going to be the host team this year at the Nationals, so they got to earn it just like everybody else.
That's right, Jake, and we're back into the live action. 7 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the second half of this game as Abella from Mohawk brings up the ball. She finds Brown. Brown looking around. She passes it, threads the needle as Hermack puts the ball in the basket.
And Coach McGinnis wanted a foul on Hermack, pushing through the screen there.
And a bit of a late whistle.
You got the foul on Jaquela Douse there. Against Mohawk, just pushing the back, and a pretty easy call to make there. That's going to send Lindsay Whitaker to the line. Whitaker, one of only two out-of-province players on the Algonquin Thunder team. The other one, Claire Abbott out of Whitehorse, as Whitaker is from Moncton, New Brunswick.
And Algonquin making the best of that opportunity and hitting both free throws as Mohawk collects the ball and brings it up the court. They move it around, they move it along the perimeter. Almost gets tripped up. Brown looking around, looking for something. Threads the needle again, and she gets fouled.
Jaquela Dowser didn't play a whole lot in that semifinal victory. Is getting some real big minutes right now with Brown in foul trouble. And even though she committed a foul now, she's going to the line. Let's see if she can make the most of this opportunity here and earn some more playing time.
She had a nice look at that. Gets the first one to go. Mohawk looking to make a couple substitutions. Bork does it again. She misses this time. But they grab the rebound. Abella throws a three up, and she
Banks it home.
She makes a call to the bank to cash out. As that brings the Mohawk fans to their feet a bit. Nice crossover move, but it's stolen away. She read that dribble. Fast break transition. She doesn't make use of it. But they grab the rebound and get blocked. And grabs, 21 grabs the block shot like a boss.
And Hermack is going to get called for the foul there. And that's her second. It looks like when she committed the foul there, she got a finger or an arm in the face there.
That was a big time block, folks. Let's hope Hermack is okay. Looks like she's in a bit of discomfort. She'll be replaced. As the Thunder got to get that ball across half court. They send it. Risky pass at the perimeter. Good defense by Mohawk. She drives. Tries her luck, and she gets it in.
And just Rada driving to the hole hard and extending that lead. Largest lead of the game right now for Algonquin. It's 15 points.
Nice play by Mohawk. As they find number five, Allison DiLorenzi, first year player from Mohawk. Nice defense by Bella.
Actually, that's going to be the fifth foul. They're going to be shooting two now. And for the next 6 minutes and 6 seconds, Algonquin's going to go to the line on every non-offensive foul against Mohawk. As Walters checks back in now for Ja'Kayla Douse.
She'll shoot two. First one is good. Ratto will try her luck at the second attempt. Second one is good. We have just about 6 minutes remaining in the first half of this gold medal OCAA championship game. Good defense. Ball stripped away. Algonquin.
A foul on Abella reaching in. That's going to be Rochelle Abella.
There you see Abella checking off for Hermack.
Hermack's back getting out with two fouls, and she replaces Abella with two fouls. So Mohawk here in some foul trouble early.
Mazarov makes that foul shot. Second shot is no good. Abella races up the court. Finds her teammate at the perimeter. She spins off the defender, uses that screen, makes a pass. Beautiful basket. Absolutely beautiful basket. Beautiful execution there. That's great teamwork. That's exactly what we want to see tonight from Mohawk.
Allison DiLorenzi, number 5, created that play. She spun out and was able to get a great pass over and allowed Jessica Rand to get it in. And the foul's being changed there. It's going to be on Jessa Ratta against Algonquin.
Jessa Ratta picks up another foul.
And that's her second, too.
Absolutely. Almost made it a three-point play. And that will be Algonquin ball.
Oh, they got it off Algonquin.
The refs has actually decided it would be Mohawk ball. It actually hit, it bounced off an Algonquin player, so Mohawk is able to make an opportunity out of this possession, hopefully. The score is 32-18, 5 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the second half of this gold medal game. That three-pointer is off the mark as the Thunder race up the court. Cupid looking for someone. Shot. Shot is good. Number 14, Lindsay Whitaker, a 5'9 forward out of Moncton, New Brunswick. Abella shoots a long three. Not this time. As Mohawk desperately needs to get closer. That shot is good.
You know, Allison DiLorenzi had a hand firmly in the back there and it went undetected, got real lucky. Algonquin ended up scoring, so I guess karma kind of bit her there.
Absolutely. She handles the ball, nearly drops her defender.
And DiLorenzi draws the foul there against Basquin, and that's going to be her second.
Couple of players to be exchanged.
Now that's only the fourth foul against Algonquin here, so now Mohawk will be in the bonus on the next Algonquin foul.
Here you see Natalie Fisher and Boric come in. Mohawk sends it to the perimeter. Abella looking to share the ball, as she usually does. Thought about a shot, hesitation, threads the needle. Oh. Foul on Algonquin. She'll be shooting two at the line. Number 23, Natalie Fisher.
Sandra Basco is in there for about 15 seconds and promptly picks up her second foul as well, too.
She doesn't look too pleased.
No, she got deked out there and was in the air and just couldn't stop herself.
It happens sometimes in the sport of basketball.
Basco's going to stay in the game with two fouls. I would have thought for sure she would have come out, but just staying in.
Natalie Fisher will try her luck at the free throw line. First one's very good.
It's one of those things as a coach, you got to look as to what's the nature of the foul. That's a foul there where Vasco really couldn't help herself. She was up in the air. Then there's some fouls where you got to take them out because they haven't adjusted to what the referee's calling.
Algonquin pushing the ball up the court. Mohawk trying to rearrange their defense. She beats them off the dribble. She loses the dribble. Cupid sends the ball down the lane. She spins around. Beautiful move. And she scores 2 points. Abella. She thought about the perimeter shot. Back to Abella. Abella calls for a play. Duffy yelling to run a certain play. Mohawk moves the ball around. Shot clock winding down. She falls away and makes it. Amazing. Simply amazing. I can't believe she made that shot.
Lauren Carey there commits a block foul. She is moving in and pushed out on the waist. And then Lisa Goldring got the underhand scoop to count.
Goldring with the circus. She brought the circus to town. That shot's no good, but she still got the 2 points. The score is 38-22 Mohawk with 3.38 seconds left as the Algonquin player gets plowed down, and the call will go against.
Natalie Fisher, number 23 there, and what that was, she just extended the arm and knocked her down there, and that's a pretty easy call to make by veteran official Joe Kemp.
Steph Hermack steps in for Abella. Rochelle Abella. Quick substitution just made. And Algonquin will be maintaining the possession.
The score table here is looking to clarify a foul there. Coming down a couple plays ago, so that's the delay there. So they bring over the calling official, he clarifies, and then we're good to go.
It seems as though Mohawk has found their groove and starting to put some points on the board here. As Algonquin turns around and gets fouled.
We got some tangled bodies there. That's Sandra Basso and Caitlin Arbor getting tangled up.
I think she was trying to tangle.
And the foul, though, is going to come on Lisa Goldring. I didn't think there was anything worthy there, neither did the officials, and that's a good call not to add anything on to either the foul or offset it there.
Sandra Basco.
Just had a few too many bodies there and not enough space.
Both free throw attempts are good for Algonquin as Mohawk comes up the court. Goldring. That pass is red and picked off. She's off to the races, folks. And that shot is uncontested as she puts two on the board for Algonquin.
That's Basco's value on this team is her defense. She's not going to be a big offensive producer, and the points that she does get will be on transition, but her value is reading the pass lane and her speed.
She's especially good at the transition. She has very long legs, allowing her to have longer strides than most of the girls on the court here.
Oh, an offensive foul there against Cupid. And Cupid's about to come out. I believe that's Cupid's third.
Coach John McInnes doing a little bit of back and forth with Cupid and his other point guard, making sure that they don't both get fouled out by exercising both of them.
That's a big foul there against Cupid.
Yeah, you have Abella back in the game. She moves the ball to the perimeter. Mohawk trying to run something. Abella looking for something. Finds Hermack. Hermack connects with the shot. That's a big time three, ladies and gentlemen. Big time three. The crowd is in a frenzy.
They gotta get a stop here to make it count.
I can hear the crowd. They say, we want more. They want more of that. As Mohawk needs to find a way to slow down Algonquin before this quarter ends. And folks, we have a player that seems to be hurt. She's on the floor right now. Let's hope everything's okay with her.
Yeah, we got a Mohawk player down, and I didn't see who went down or how she went down. Some of the crowd here, I think it was a headshot, although, I mean, some of the crowd does tend to overreact.
That's no good. I believe that's Abella that's on the ground. So for those folks who didn't see what happened, let's take another look here. Abella on defense here. Seems as though she ran into a moving screen.
Yeah, that's a hard pick there, but a good legal pick.
Took an elbow to the face, it looks like.
We're going to try to bring up the replay here one more time and see if we can do that in the truck and take another look at that. So, you know, watch 21 come up. She's going to set the screen. She's good set and just kind of knocks her down. And nothing real sinister there. It's a good hard, it's a hard foul, but it's a legal foul there. Her feet were set. Arms were protecting the chest there in one of the two legal positions. You can, the women can have their arms up on their chest, making a cross over their breast, and typically the men have kind of a V over the crotch there. It's really choice, but the arms have to be within the body, and that's what they were.
So like you said, that was completely legal. So like I said before, let's just hope everything's okay with her.
And it looks like Abella went down or had her head lowered too. So when you run into a player like Jessica Basquin, who's 6'1 and built like a house too, it's going to hurt. You're going to run into a brick wall.
Yeah, she's built pretty solid, folks. And Abella had to recognize. You can see the Mohawk team here talking things over, trying to come up with a replacement effort. Most likely it will be her sister, Jenna Bella.
And actually, speaking of her sister, she just walked out onto the floor there. Make sure that she's okay. And Abella hasn't moved. Rochelle Abella hasn't moved since she ran into the screen there.
Well, actually, her fingers are beginning to move. She seems like she's talking. And by the look on the...
She's moving her leg now, which is always a good sign. So 2:21 to go here before half. It's Algonquin 44, Mohawk 25, and we have Rochelle Abella down on the floor right now. She's stirred a little bit since she went down. Her legs have moved a little bit, and so have her fingers. The trainers are being cautious.
Here you see a David Brilley Athletic Center nearly sold out. A couple of empty spots, but for the most part of it. So once again, the score is 44, Algonquin, and Mohawk 25, with 2 minutes and 21 seconds remaining in the first half of the game. Everybody just standing by and making sure everything's okay before we continue on with the game. Quite a competitive sport, and today would be even actually more competitive because these girls are competing for a gold medal. Yeah. She's slowly making her way.
It's Jenna Bella now, or excuse me, Rochelle Bella now, just starting to stir.
She's slowly making her way up, folks. And there you have it, folks. She seems to be doing all right thus far.
They're just going to take a minute here and get the sweat off the floor.
Rochelle Bella will be seen by the trainers here at Mohawk.
So we're going to have a sub in here for Algonquin and for Mohawk. Coming into the game for Algonquin is Amber Burton, and for Mohawk is Karina Brown. So Brown's back into the game with two fouls and 2:21 to go.
So we're back in the game. Second quarter of this OCAA Women's Champion Gold Championship game. As she nearly loses the ball out of bounds, it will be awarded to Algonquin. As Algonquin looks to inbound the ball. And here we go, folks. Mazaral moves the ball to the perimeter. She drives in, finds someone in the perimeter. Finds her other teammate, post player. She looks to shoot, gets blocked or pieced, but they're able to get the rebound, and she double dribbles.
Double dribble first there, and another turnover there by Algonquin.
And here you see Mohawk making the substitution.
And that's Rochelle Abella coming in here, gentle and injured. Rochelle into the game now.
Absolutely, now you see.
Seconds to go in the half. Mohawk down 19.
The ball has got intercepted by Algonquin. Algonquin a bit lazy with that pass, almost lost it. She thought about the shot, looking for the post player. The post player.
And we have a foul there against Algonquin. Amber Burton, they push her, forcing Brown up. And two shots coming.
So Brown will shoot two. First shot, just a bit short. About a minute and 17 seconds remaining in the game, folks. As Karina Brown makes that shot.
Got the second there, and Mohawk here really needs to stop. They need to stop and score real quick.
She traveled. She succumbed to the defense of Mohawk as Mazaral and Lauren Carey make an exchange substitution here.
So that's a big turnover right there because now you get Mohawk a chance to cut in. You can't cut in if you're trading.
Rochelle Bella drives. That one's a bit off the mark.
Walters is going to travel there. She took too many steps.
Walters with a little up and down. There's 57.7 seconds remaining in this first half of the game. The Thunder look at the perimeter. She cuts and drives.
And one.
Tough shot as she's fouled by Lacey Walters.
And that's going to be on Karina Brown, and that's her third foul there.
Pardon me, the foul went to Karina Brown. Looked like Walters.
I thought it was going to be Walters too, but coming out of the crowd was Karina Brown.
Karina Brown showing that aggression.
Lisa Golding checking in for Brown now. Yeah. 47 seconds, wants to keep her on the bench.
Abella grabs the rebound.
We haven't seen Carissa Brown since the early moments of this game.
Now you see them at the perimeter. They need a nice close shot. No three-pointers right now. She shoots it, and she makes the air one. Athletic, athleticism at its finest. Isabella pops and skips in the air for that and one.
And that's how it's gonna go to Jeff Arada there with a little push.
She got the hoop in the arm.
All Jeff McGinnis can do is just look on there. Couldn't believe that ball went in.
Can she make it a three-point play? Absolutely, she makes it a three-point play. 46-29, Mohawk.
Needs to string it together now. Another stop here would be great for Mohawk and some momentum heading into the break.
She thought about it.
And they're gonna get Walters for the push there.
Walters took that foul. And Basquin will shoot two. Let's see what she can do. That shot is off. She'll try her luck again in her second free throw attempt coming up. Second one doesn't fall.
Missed them both.
Abella, heavily guarded by Algonquin. She calls for a play. 5 seconds left. She almost makes it, and then she gets blocked as Algonquin closes the first half of the game with 46 points, and Mohawk with 29 points in the 2014 OCAA championship game. Let's take a look at the highlights from this first half of the game. As you see Hermack with a nice thread the needle, and then you see Algonquin with that nice transition. Mohawk showing their offensive skills, and as well as Algonquin. Mohawk with the deep three, cashing out at the bank.
That's been Algonquin's game here. Almost all the highlights, we saw them score three baskets on that package. They were all in transition and all within a foot of the basket. That's how they're scoring so far.
Absolutely. So we're about to start off the third quarter. We just finished up the second quarter. We're signing off here. Until next time, Alvin Drent and Jake Parker.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time.
Hello again, and welcome to the David Brilley Athletic Center. Over here at Mohawk, as we host the OCAA Women's Championship game. And I'm Alvin Drent, along here with Jake Parkhill. We're watching the second half of Mohawk take on Algonquin.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a very good first half here so far. A couple of notes here. First off, I want to go over some foul trouble. It's going to play a rather large role here. First for Mohawk, Rochelle Abella and Kareen Brown, both with three. And then with Steph Hermack and Carissa Brown with two. For Algonquin, three fouls to Kim Cupid and then a handful of players with two. So you have to keep your eyes out on that there. And speaking of a handful of fouls there, we got one coming up here. 12 seconds in, it's gonna be on Jess Ratta, and that's gonna be her third personal foul early on here. Algonquin points per shot. They're at 1.21, which is an impressive rate here, and they have 30 points in the paint. And a lot of those are transition, six steals on that, but a lot of them in transition there. So 30 out of 46 points are coming in transition there and in the paint.
As you can see here, Mohawk maintains the possession after Algonquin kicks the ball out of bounds. Brown drives in, finds her teammate. She's able to connect on that. Algonquin inbounding the ball. They pass it back and forth. She's looking around, looking for her options. Mohawk playing that tough defense. Brown on defense. She gets left and almost gets scored on as that basket doesn't drop for Mohawk. Mohawk looking to make opportunity of this fast break. They drop the ball out of bounds. Steph Hermack fell out of bounds on that play.
Yeah, this is a big series right now here for Mohawk. This two-pack possession here, they can get another stop and a bucket here. They'll bring it to within 13. Closest it's been since about midway through the second quarter.
Keep in mind, folks, this is the OCAA championship gold game. Algonquin is undefeated this season as they show their expertise at the three.
That's going to be a two there, foot on the line.
Oh, she had her foot on the line. Excuse me, that's a two. As you see Hermack gathering up her players, and that pass was read by Algonquin.
Hermack just throws it away there, and another turnover. That's going to be the 14th turnover of the night there for Mohawk. At 12 in the first half, two in the first 80 seconds so far.
Good defense by Mohawk here, trying to keep them away from the basket. And somehow she gets it to drop. Number eight.
The one thing about that play there, Claire Abbott had her eyes on the rim the entire time. When you're going into the basket, you keep your eye on the rim, and that's where the ball's going to go.
That pass is intercepted, and Mazara takes it all the way. She gets hit hard, and she'll shoot two at the line. Mohawk has one team foul, and Algonquin has also one team foul, as we have 8 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in this third quarter, folks.
And Jessica Grant going to pick up the foul there, and that's...
Jenna Bella enters back in the game after we saw her in the second quarter struggling to get up. She steps in for Hermack.
Yeah, she took that. She hit with that pick there and was down for several minutes. It's good to see her back in the game.
Absolutely. It's more than good to see her back because she's a big contributor to this team, and hopefully she can help them pull through this deficit that they're facing. As Algonquin hits that free throw, Mohawk bringing up the ball. Jenna Bella back, ready. She looks around, finds Brown. Brown finds the perimeter. She goes baseline. Excuse me, she goes down the lane. Abella just off the mark. As they struggle to get the ball, and it's going to be Algonquin ball.
Have a held ball there. Coach McGinnis of Algonquin wanted a holding foul there.
Here we see Algonquin inbounding the ball. They got to get out of the half court.
Well, they make putting it. Some pressure on. They had two people on the ball, and Brown there saved herself from doing a split to left her man open for three.
She was doing the splits while Algonquin was throwing the three.
That's one of those. She just slipped on the floor there.
Now Bella.
Algonquin doing a great job keeping the crowd out of the game here. They're ready to explode, but
three ball. That ball's no good.
They've scored a few and kept them out.
The call is going to be.
Algonquin turns it over there. They lost it out of bounds.
Absolutely. The ball is in Mohawk's favor. The time right now is 7 minutes and 22 seconds. 55-31. Algonquin is in the lead. Third quarter. Here you see Mohawk inbounding the ball. Allison DiLorenzi on the inbound. Looking for someone. Looking for something. They find Abella. Abella sends it across the perimeter to her sister. She uses that pick, runs off the pick, loses her dribble, and that actually was last touched by Algonquin. So it's going to be Mohawk ball with 14 seconds remaining on the shot clock.
So Mohawk here has plenty of time on the shot clock here. They don't have to take the first shot.
That shot is off the mark. Algonquin wastes no time collecting the rebound and utilizing that fast break as there's no foul, but instead, out of bounds.
It, you know, Abella really got away with one there. They got her on the ball there, but she might have had some rest there too, and that's what McGinnis was saying.
I heard a bit of skin, but nonetheless, Mohawk gets the ball. Fast break transition. They slow it down. She regroups. Passes it to her sister. Down in the post. Lacey Walters.
Walters, what a big play there. What a big play by Walters.
And that's a really important play because she could possibly make it a three-point play at this moment.
Well, that's going to be good for her self-confidence, too, here. The first three shots of the game that she had were off. And heading into the half here.
Some exchanges being made, 24 for 21.
Walters was 0 for 2 and had a couple bad bad shots in that.
Let's see if Walters can make it. She makes it. A three-point play, ladies and gentlemen, as Algonquin inbounds the ball, highly pressured half-court trap. didn't quite work. Algonquin perseveres through the trap. They send the ball across the perimeter. She thought about the shot. She drives baseline, passes it. That shot's no good. It'll be a charge ball.
Django against Mazarol there, and on Felicia, that's going to be her third foul there, and the point guards for Algonquin are all in foul trouble.
You know, with the deficit like Mohawk is having right now, and only 6 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in this third quarter, they got to make sure they're careful with every move they make. Every basket counts at this point.
Well, that was great defense right there by Basquin there. She stood straight up and let the Mohawk player just tumble down on her side. Lesson two.
That three ball is good by number 14, Lindsay Whitaker, 5'9 forward out of Moncton, New Brunswick. You see Mohawk here. Abella uses the screen. Screen doesn't work. She passes it. She thought about it. Double team.
Oh,
nearly got fouled. Instead, Lacey Walters picks up the pass and is awarded with the points.
That was a great pass by Abella. She recognized the double team and got it over to Walters, who was able to convert for two.
Bringing Mohawk that much closer. 5 minutes and 31 seconds remaining as they drive hard to the hoop and she falls and is unable to make the basket, using her hands to slow down the Mohawk player, but it doesn't work. She has a good look at it. Not the greatest shot as that ball goes out of bounds and it'll be Algonquin ball.
Long shot, long rebound there, and all the Mohawk players were in close to the basket, so the ball bounces over their head and out of bounds.
Here you see the Mohawk bench and Coach Duffy standing along with his teammate, giving some encouragement to the substitutions that were just made. Here you see Cupid makes her return to the game. She sprints across the court, passes it to the perimeter. She looks for her options, looking for something, finds nothing. Karina Brown takes a fall, but she ate it and gets up.
That's her argument that she got bumped there, but I'm not sure it was enough contact to warrant a foul there.
There you see Karina Brown. Nice see Algonquin. Cupid passes it to the perimeter. They're looking for a three, obviously. They can't get it. That Mohawk defense is intense. Mohawk trying to come up with a stop. They stop it. They strip it. They run down the court. That dribble is picked off by Algonquin. Algonquin looking to make a fast break. They decide to slow it down. At the perimeter, Cupid. Cupid looking at her options. She decides to shoot, and she drains it.
Oh.
That's a sweet-looking shot by Cupid.
She's got ice water in her veins, as Kim Cupid. And another big-time J from a girl that's been hitting them all weekend long.
Absolutely.
Just as the crowd's getting back into it here, they stretch the lead back to 23 points. Does Algonquin here, and they're doing a great job taking the crowd out of the game right now. And that's the one key when you're playing on the road. You got to keep the crowd out of it as McGinnis here talks to his team. Duffy here, they got to, what they really have to do is create some momentum. And the best way to do that right now for Mohawk is to get a stop and then a steal. And if you can get that stop and steal, you're getting positive points here. You got to look at these possessions here in two-pack possessions or three-pack possessions here. Win the packs and come out and not worry about, you know, what happens before this point now. You're down 23 points, get a stop, get a steal, and come back and do it again.
Absolutely. As we have 4 minutes and 34 seconds remaining in the quarter, Mohawk looking to make a comeback of some sort.
You know, one thing here is there's 14 minutes and 34 seconds remaining in the game right now. So Mohawk here, they're not in a great spot, but it's still possible. 23 points in 14 minutes is not exactly impossible. It's about a basket every buck 15 or so that you got a game.
Let's make some noise.
You're absolutely right as Mohawk inbounds the ball and tries to make something of this play. finds Karina. They move the ball, find a cutter. Beautiful look. As number five, Allison DiLorenzi makes that play work. Double team on Cupid. They find a way out of it. Good defense by Mohawk. Out rebounded. She thought the ball was going in. She walked away from the shot. Never assumed.
Walters avoided a foul there because she was playing above Cupid. So Cupid here wasn't in her vertical space, and that's why she avoided the foul down low.
There you have Mohawk moving the ball along nicely. She's looking for something, find someone. She falls, but Karina catches it, and that three is no good. And elbow's just swinging as Algonquin rebounds the ball and brings the ball back up the court. They're moving the ball. She's looking for something.
The elbows are swinging, but didn't contact anybody.
You're absolutely right. As that pass is picked off, Mohawk looking to make opportunity of this play. They slow it down. Regroup.
Yeah. Thunder did really well. Just Arata was the one back there and stopped the drive there. And Brown had nobody to pass to, so a good play to move it out. Just didn't execute there.
Sarah Ferguson steps in.
Three changes in here for Mohawk. Hermax into the game, and so is Fisher, and so is Douse. All returning. Douse had some big minutes in the first half.
Algonquin shoots that long two, and it's off the mark. But that ball goes out of bounds and into the hands of a fan. And back into the hands of a referee as Mohawk inbounds the ball. A couple of substitutions made for Mohawk and Algonquin. See here Abella taking the ball up. Looking to make a play. She's double teamed. She passes it off. That pass is almost picked off as they put up a shot, and that shot's no good. Back in the hands of a Mohawk player. That shot gets blocked off the backboard.
Goldring had great position. She just didn't realize where she was.
Nice feed by Cupid as Abella tried to take the charge, but no charge there. Abella sharing the ball. She drives.
In all this right now, Algonquin is maintaining and then expanding their lead right now. It's a 25-point advantage here, and since the last time out there, it was 20-23, so they've gone plus two.
You're absolutely right, and Mohawk's inbounding the ball. 2 minutes and 19 seconds remaining in this third quarter of this gold medal NCAA championship game. You have Cupid here. She stops and pops, and that shot's no good. She's usually good from that spot, but not this time as Mohawk grabs the rebound, and Abella brings up the ball.
The next time you watch Algonquin come out, they had three people in transition there, so Cupid had options. They recovered that point, but when you're watching them on the break here, you watch for the options to come out, and that's where they're deadly.
Abella with a shot of her own, and that one is no good. Looks like it will be Mohawk ball as Abella's sister, Rochelle Abella, steps in.
It was off Cupid there. They were fighting for the ball there, and Cupid knocked it away. I didn't think that she did, but nonetheless.
Some ball movement going on here. As she drives, crosses over, passes it back. Nearly traveled. Lost the ball. Algonquin in transition. That shot, she took a while, and she made that shot. She took her sweet time and made a sweet shot.
Lauren Carey, the trail runner there, comes out and just gets her spot on the floor and nails a three. That was a fantastic series there for Algonquin.
Absolutely. She catches it at the perimeter, gives it back. Abella looking to share it. 8 seconds left on the shot clock here for Mohawk. Just under a minute left in the third quarter. That pass is almost picked off. She maintains it,
and
but the shot
get
doesn't
off.
Get off in time. The score here is 64-38, folks, here at the David Brilley Athletic Center with 52 5.2 seconds remaining in the third quarter of this gold medal game. What we need here is just a little more inspiration from the fans over here, the David Braley. Give our players here some motivation. They've been a bit quiet in the last few plays. It's time for Mo the Hawk to wild up the crowd as she looks for the basket, couldn't find the bottom of the mesh though. And she gets fouled though, making use of her time there in that
Sarah position. Sarah Ferguson's gonna get called for the foul, and she kind of got in on the double whammy there. She was inside the no charge semicircle, and she moved in to the shot there as Natalie Fisher was going up.
And like I said before, Mazaral switches out for Cupid. The coach doing a little more back and forth of utilizing both of those players.
Well, both of them have three fouls right now, and with 30 seconds to go in the third quarter, it's not as big a deal as it is at the start of the third, but you know, still three fouls. You're in a bit of a danger zone here with 10 minutes and 30 seconds to play.
That's very true. 30 seconds, and Algonquin does have five fouls. Mohawk only has two team fouls. This is Algonquin ball right now. They send it across, risky pass. Mazaral, risky pass, and it's read by Mohawk, and it will remain in Algonquin's possession.
Actually, the first half, there are 31 combined fouls in between the two teams. So far, it's seven. And it's been, they've really cleaned it up, and that's kudos to both coaches to recognize what's being called.
Absolutely. She trips and falls. Mohawk looking to make a fast break. They slow it down. Good choice. As they find their post player who the ball is knocked off by Algonquin. It will remain in Mohawk possession. 10 seconds left of this third quarter. This gold medal game. Mohawk looking to inbound. Did they find Abella? Abella open look, no contest. But she puts another basket in the hoop. 64 to 41, 3 seconds left. Will they get it off in time? Nope, they won't. There you have it.
It's a 23-point lead right now heading into the fourth quarter for Algonquin, 64-41. And
let's take a look at that highlight package of the third quarter, that exciting third quarter. Algonquin showing their offensive skills, as you see there. Lacey Walters, that turnaround. And there you see Mohawk, the bench there, having a talk with each other. Looks like Coach Duffy is out of the huddle.
Yeah, the key here, 2 minutes is a long time for a coach to speak to their players. So what you really want is you want about 40 seconds to go in there. So you talk to your assistant coaches, and Duffy's going to step in now, all right, and then talk to the players here. But 2 minutes is really a long time because you want your messages to be short and simple. Drop a couple plays and then go from there. You're not going to be able to script 5 minutes of basketball. It's unrealistic to think that. So when you're in a huddle here, you want to keep it short, keep it simple, and get some key points across.
And here you see the Algonquin team speaking with their coach, and they're excited. Smiles on their faces.
They should be. They're up 24 with 10 minutes to go to a fourth consecutive championship.
Absolutely. They have a nice, good, healthy lead. But you know, this is basketball, and a lot of things can happen in this next quarter. Let's hope that Mohawk can turn things around and produce that gold.
Now, right now, what they need to work on here is their offensive efficiency. In the first half, they were shooting at points per shot of 0.63, so about for every two shots, they're getting 1 point there, and a little better than that. And that's real tough to contend with when, first off, Algonquin had 30 points in the paint, and it's improved upon that. And they were at 1.21 points per shot as well, too. Those are big deals when you're trying to make a comeback.
There you see Mohawk.
Oh, and one.
And one. Amazing acrobatic shot as number five.
Amber Burton there commits a foul, and it wasn't a good foul either. It's 2 points easy, and that's only her second foul, but it's a big one.
Absolutely. She makes that a three-point play. And Algonquin brings up the ball. 9 minutes and 48 seconds remaining in this game, folks. Long shot, no good. Rebounded by Algonquin. Looks like Mohawk has turned up the pressure of their defense, and they're heavily guarding Algonquin. And it looks like it's going to be a call against Algonquin.
Yeah, that's a moving screen there against Sandra Basco. She never set her feet on the screen, so when she makes contact there, she's still moving. It's going to be an illegal screen, and Mohawk basketball.
These refs are on top of everything today. As 21 subs out for 24, and as well, 10 comes in for number 5.
Yeah, Basquin's coming in here. That's the third foul on Basco, number 24, as she takes a seat early in the fourth quarter.
Here you have Abella to Abella. In the post, a little too high. She's not as tall as she thought she was. As Algonquin collects the turnover and brings up the ball. 64-44. Algonquin in the lead. Double team. Good defense by Mohawk. That shot is off the mark, but rebounded by Algonquin. She turns around and puts it back, cleans up the mess.
Sarah Ferguson with an all-effort point there, and in comes Walters with another two. They gotta get a stop here for Mohawk. 20-point difference.
Here you have Algonquin, uses the screen, cuts in the hoop, doesn't get the shot off, hard rebound.
And we have a held ball coming up here, and it's gonna stay with Algonquin on the alternating possession arrow.
Absolutely. Algonquin rebounds the ball, inbounds the ball. They find a cutter, she turns around, Lacey's all over that, and somehow she gets the friendly roll. Bringing the lead.
Walters puts it up and in.
Walters had a good look at that one. As Algonquin wastes no time trying to stack those points on the board. They're double team, triple team. Triple team. Bad pass. Karina Brown. As she gets the charge call.
That's a big foul there on Brown. It's going to be her third personal. That's her fourth personal.
Lauren Carey doing a great job absorbing that charge.
Excuse me, I got the Brown sisters confused there. That was 22 Carissa. That's her third personal foul there on the charge, sending the arm.
Algonquin trying to make use of this possession. They move the ball around. A long two.
Oh, that's a trifecta.
Excuse me, a long three.
And the celebration starting on the Algonquin bench.
7 minutes and 25 seconds. As Mohawk just not taking the time they need to score. Feels a bit rushed. Not too sure if they're...
Foul's going to be there on Abella.
Overwhelmed by the lead.
We have a timeout.
The most important thing that Mohawk needs to do with this much time left is not to give up, because 7 minutes and 20 seconds is plenty of time to turn things around.
71-46 right now, and right now you pretty much need to stop them in their tracks and get a whole bunch of baskets. Now, Algonquin's getting to the point now where they're thinking about a couple more points and we're going to be champions here. And they have been impressive in this tournament here. They started off by blowing out Fanshawe by 30 points, and then they took down a pretty game St. Clair team, and actually bronze medalist St. Clair team last night by 27. We called that one there, and that was one of the most impressive displays I think I've ever seen in women's ball there by Algonquin last night, and right now they're up big against Mohawk.
Here you see the Algonquin bench discussing what they need to do to come home with this gold, or at least maintain the lead. Keep in mind, folks, like I said earlier, Algonquin is coming, entering this tournament with a perfect record of 16-0, and finished number one in the East Division, winning every game by double digits. So they're showing Mohawk the reason why they finished first, and they're undefeated. But Mohawk is also not to be underestimated as well, because they have a very good record as well in the regular season, as we have Algonquin running up the court.
And you're looking at two of the three medalists coming out of the West Division, and St. Lawrence, probably the second best team out of the East, who's really not too much of a match for Algonquin here and there. They've taken out three West teams, and they've done it impressively here, this tournament here. It's been quite the showing so far.
Absolutely. As we have number 23, Katie Lansbury, making her appearance out of Ottawa, Ontario, standing at 5'11". And she's a first-year player on Algonquin. Second attempt is good, bringing the lead to 72-48. Abella. Pass is miscommunicated. She's off to the races. Easy basket, but just a little too hard on the release.
That's going to go Mohawk way there. It's just kind of volleyed out.
I'm telling you, they just need a few stops, Jake, and they can get the momentum going again.
You know, you could be right. I could also be turning into my father, too. I mean, he's always one to declare games over pretty early, so.
It's never over until it's over.
The great Yogi Berra said that.
Was that Yogi?
That was Yogi.
As you see Karina Brown put the ball in the basket.
As most of our great sports expressions are from Yogi Berra.
That's what they say. Algonquin drives. That shot's an air ball. And it's going to be Algonquin ball. Things are not looking too bright for our Falcons, but
the referees here are going to conference here. They're not sure about the shot clock, and they're going to have a full reset and a full 24. But hit the rim, and no change of possession, so Algonquin here will get a fresh 24. And right now they can run some clock off here.
They have a lot of clock. Early shot, kind of forced. Wasn't expecting that pass, that's all right. They still maintain possession.
Oh, it's a good heads-up play by Ja'Kayla Dowser to get rid of the ball. She's not a ball handler, but unfortunately there, Brown wasn't looking. Fortunately for her, Abella was right there to scramble up and get the ball.
A little bit of miscommunication. Looks like Brown passed that out of, because she was desperate, she did what she had to do. Algonquin. Looking to make Mohawk pay for that last possession. She takes off, passes it. She's been hot. Lansbury coming off the bench, smoking hot. Nice ball rotation. Double teamed, triple teamed. That won't fall. But she will make a trip to the line and shoot two.
That's Ja'Kayla Dowser making something out of nothing there. She was in tight and was able to get a foul. And Ryda had really no choice but to foul her there, as she was either going to go back or commit. So she committed that foul there. And we have Natalie Walters waiting in here. So Dowser will come out if she makes the second free throw.
First shot is no good by Ja'Kayla Dowser. She'll try again.
It's been a good weekend here for the Mohawk basketball program into the Final Four in the men's side.
It's been an amazing weekend thus far.
Women's team in the gold medal game here.
Absolutely. The lead is now 74-51, Algonquin.
And we'd like to extend our congratulations to Matthew Schnarr and the men's volleyball team. They took home the OCAA championship last weekend. The banner hanging, the fresh banner hanging.
That shot is off. Cupid with the high flying vertical rebound.
And Cupid's spent two lines. And the officials there coming over talking to Duffy, who is getting excited on that three in the key call.
As we just saw Cupid smiling about that error. She's smiling because Algonquin can afford that error with the lead that they have. Abella goes hard to the hoop and draws the foul. She's not giving up, definitely, that's for sure.
I got a foul there on Kitty Flansbury, a freshman out of Ottawa, and just pushing the shooter. And two shots coming to Rochelle.
First shot is good.
Algonquin's at the limit right now for fouls, so Mohawk will be shooting two shots every foul now. Rest of the game.
Rebounded by Lacey. Abella shoots that three. No good.
Oh, a big rebound there by Hermack. An all-effort rebound once again.
Nearly walks. That shot didn't drop. It's rebounded by Walters. Then pass to Abella. Abella goes all the way from the bottom of the court to the top and makes that basket.
That was a great coast-to-coast lay-in right there.
She threads the needle.
Shane Tevet O'Bannon in the first-round survival in 95 for UCLA. Coast-to-coast with 4 seconds to go to keep UCLA alive.
Here you have Abella bringing up the ball. You see Mohawk good at rotating the ball. Hermack splashes it.
And that's a two there for Hermack. Her foot was on the line.
It was a two, but she still splashed it. Algonquin passed it the wrong person.
Back
wrong
away.
Teammate. That ball rolls away, but back into the hands of Algonquin as Flansbury makes use of that roll ball.
That is pure effort right there for Algonquin to get that loose ball. 3.5 to go.
76-58. Not too late to make the comeback, but Flansbury wants that goal way more than Mohawk does, apparently, as they intercept that pass and try to solidify and secure that lead that they have. Will it count? No, it doesn't, because she's unable to make it. Abella thinks about it, sees her post player, easy basket.
Right in. Fisher there running the floor well. She moved 90 feet to make that basket happen.
Cupid back in action. Flansbury. She looks for someone, finds her, spins around, almost lost the ball. Mohawk needs to play much higher defensively. And that's what I'm talking about when I say defense.
We got an offensive foul there up against Jessica Rada there. And McGinnis here wondering where the defender was. He thought it was inside the charge circle, but you can be below the charge circle and be okay. The charge circle is only the semicircle as painted. It doesn't go below that there. So that was kind of the key. It looked like she might have been below the charge circle.
2 minutes and 33 seconds. Mohawk needs to score 16 points in 2 minutes and 33 seconds.
And we have a timeout charged to Mohawk with 2.5 to play here. So
Algonquin needs to be careful, actually, because they are in foul trouble.
Yeah, Algonquin's at the limit right now, and Mohawk's cut into the deficit right now. It's about a plus 10 for Mohawk's side over the past about 2 minutes or so, but unfortunately right now it's just not quick enough. They need to speed up the pace of their comeback here as they're still down 16.
If Coach Duffy is able to help them execute a few plays, they will be able to at least get within 10 and change the whole pace of the game.
Yeah, no.
And now, as far as Algonquin is concerned.
Yeah, Algonquin here, McGinnis right now, you just can't have anything catastrophic happen. So, value the ball. They're still going to play at an up-tempo pace. This isn't a team to slow things down. With the pro and con of that is they're going to be able to score quickly, but it's also going to give Mohawk some more possessions when they don't score. So, more or less here, they need to make sure that they're going to get buckets on quick possessions, and if they don't, they're going to open the door here for Mohawk. 8 possessions in this game. It will not take a lot of time, but it should only take about 100 seconds at this break.
That's right, and Mohawk here, long pass.
And it's going to be a block on Felicia Mesrol, but McGinnis here wants a hook.
And that's exactly what I'm talking about. They have to watch out because they are in foul trouble. And like you said, every foul will bring Mohawk to the line, which is actually to our advantage.
The second half of that is they're going to be able to convert while the clock is stopped as Abella makes the first one here.
76-61, not too far away. That shot was detrimental to go in, but
knocked out of bounds there by Whitaker.
How the tables have turned, folks. Mohawk ball. They have a chance of making this a 3-point play in the last two possessions. And possibly 4-point play if they hit a 3. They decide to take a 2, and she's fouled. Unbelievable.
Not sure they're going to get Cupid or Whitaker on that one. And they're going to get Whitaker on that one there. And Cupid was right in the area there. As close as she could have picked up her 4th.
Jessica Basquin coming in for Lindsay Whitaker. They need Basquin's athleticism and height to secure that lead and make sure Mohawk doesn't make a comeback.
Well, since that timeout right now, Mohawk's 1-for-3 from the free throw line. They've had their opportunities here.
That one drops. Minutes and 21 seconds remaining in the game here at David Brilley Athletic Center.
What that was there was the ball was supposed to Bella thought it was live, but Algonquin hadn't possessed it out of bounds, so it was not live, and that's why the official stopped in. We got a charge.
Bella getting her acting on as she absorbs the charge. Very smart basketball right there. The refs bought it.
And I believe now that's 5 on Mazarol. It is. That's her 5th.
Does that mean she's out of here?
Yeah, Mazarol's been disqualified there.
She can take a seat.
So they got 30 seconds here to find a replacement, and Coach McGinnis is going to use that time. All right.
So let's see that charge.
And now Mazarol there extends the arm here. Let's see if we can get that. She extends the arm there, and when she does, that's the foul.
We'll take a look at it again. Or not.
Looks like we're back to live action here, so we'll keep that.
Abella. Mohawk ball. 2 minutes and 4 seconds, plenty of time. Mohawk will inbound the ball. Crowd still into it. That one was no good as Algonquin rebounds. Mohawk needs to play hard and come up with a steal or some sort of stop. Anything but a foul. Algonquin looking at their options. They come up with a steal. Abella saves it. Just so close. Good teamwork, though.
Bella was just a little out of control right there, and the pass was just that much off there.
A minute and 35 seconds remaining. Cupid getting her handle on, nearly dropping Abella. She takes off, looks for someone. She finds 21. She sends it across the court at the perimeter. She drives, no look pass, and nearly threw out of bounds. As Mohawk sends the ball up the court, can she make it?
There's going to be a foul there on Algonquin.
She gets tripped up, and she's going to shoot two, a well-deserved two.
Lauren Carey there picks up the foul. There's no easy basket so in this game.
Absolutely not. This is a gold medal game. Everybody has to work for everything. And the game is coming nearing within 10, like I said.
Yeah, they're down to 13 here. Mohawk staged quite the comeback.
They needed that free throw, though.
Yeah, they're about 50% in the last 90 seconds on the line. About 3 for 6. They've had their opportunities.
They need to apply pressure on this defense right now. They need to. Almost picked off the pass. We need to stop this possession. She traveled.
She did travel.
Too much walking.
It's little jab steps, but it's still a travel. And we have a timeout that's going to be charged to Mohawk.
49 seconds to make a comeback.
Now the important thing there, and McGinnis kind of looked upset there, and the reason why was Mohawk calls a timeout under 2 minutes, so they get the ball advanced to the front court. Had it been charged to Algonquin, it's Mohawk's ball, but about 40 feet back there, and that's why I was a little upset they didn't get charged a timeout. It's one of those things where the score table controls timeouts in FIBA, so it's based on who asked first. And we got the ruling that they both roughly asked at the same time. Mohawk got the timeout in, and they'll be able to advance the ball.
Absolutely. We see here the Algonquin Thunder coming up with their plans for the last 49 seconds. And here we have Mohawk separating before it's time to go back on the court. Coach Duffy, we see there. They've had a good season thus far.
Yeah, so Mohawk's going to get the ball at the 28-foot mark. And down 13 here. They got to be looking for some trifectas here.
It's the OCAA gold game, the women's gold game here.
Walters puts it in for two. And down goes Kermack. Kermack and Walters collided coming out there, and
they're okay.
Yeah, Hermack went down, but it's going to be an Algonquin ball, and they just kind of went into each other.
Ref is asking to get the clock reset.
Yeah, the shot clock had ticked down there, but they're going to award the ball out of bounds and not penalize Algonquin on that play.
Good defense by Abella. Cupid fast on her feet. Ooh, a stop. Quick stop.
Now for those stat people here, a possession for Algonquin would mean every victory over 10. But a stop here by Mohawk in a basket, they could cut that within 10.
She's unable to put it in.
And it's going to stay Algonquin ball.
Algonquin giving signs of a victory.
A great ovation there for Abella. That's her last play of the year there. Fourth-year player.
It will remain Algonquin possession. 15 seconds remaining in the 2014 OCAA Women's Gold Medal Championship game. Algonquin here with the ball. They'll try to run down the clock, and I think Mohawk will allow them.
Walters comes out with some token pressure, but Algonquin's going to take their fourth straight title.
Mohawk squats to the very final second as Algonquin celebrates a well-deserved season, a perfect 16-0 season, and a few more victories here in this tournament. And the most important victory of them all, the OCAA Women's Championship gold medal game.
It's an 11-point victory tonight, but it was a far more impressive victory overall, and they really played some of their best basketball of the tournament tonight and fought off a very game Mohawk team.
And here you see Coach Duffy's Falcons coming together, talking things out, going back to the drawing boards, figuring things out for next season. And Algonquin here preparing to receive their medals very shortly here, folks, at the David Braley Athletic Center here at Mohawk. Good sportsmanlike conduct right here. Acknowledging each other, acknowledging the win.
The one positive here for Mohawk, they have three senior players on the team and the rest of them are very young players. And they're gonna look to reload into next year. For Algonquin here, it's not as much of a laden team, it's more of a balanced team, and they're trying to build for years and years to come. Look forward to this matchup in the next couple of years as well, too.
Interestingly enough, the only player on Algonquin that won't be returning next year, as far as her eligibility is concerned, is Sandra Basquio, who's a fifth-year player.
Yeah, Basquio and Masrol. Masrol in her fourth year, always the option there.
You're absolutely right. And stand by as we wait for the players of Algonquin to receive their medals.
And
well
Mohawk.
Deserved.
Oh, we're going to start off here. We have some Player of the Game awards here. And Lacey Walters earning the Player of the Game for Mohawk. Really had an outstanding game. She had a few fluffs in the first half, but really rebounded well and played great defense throughout.
Absolutely.
From Algonquin College, number 10, Jessa Rada.
Jessa Rada, who had just a fantastic game. They well deserved. Now we're going to go into the medal presentations here.
Time for the gold to be handed out.
We have the All-Star presentation here, and we'll turn it over.
From St. Lawrence College, number 14, Lacey Knox.
Lacey Knox from St. Lawrence College, named for the tournament All-Star team. There are some St. Lawrence players hanging
from
around here.
St. Clair College, number 14, Shannon Kennedy.
That's Shannon Kennedy from St. Clair, both members part of that bronze medal game we saw earlier
from
tonight.
Mohawk College, number 3, Rachel Labella.
Rachel Labella.
Labella, well deserved. Well deserved for her.
Hey, Rach.
From Mohawk College, number 11, Jen Abella.
Here we have her sister.
And the Abella sisters going on to the tournament All-Star team.
Daisy Cupid, very athletic player.
Well deserving as well too. She had a great tournament.
Spectacular tournament. Daisy.
Sandre Basquio there, the tournament MVP. She played a great final game and had a real impact in that semifinal victory against St. Clair.
Absolutely. As you see Algonquin celebrating.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mohawk would like to welcome Greg Treelock, applied to BMW Hamilton, to present the silver medal.
So we have Greg Treelock here of BMW Hamilton, Bud's BMW, one of the tournament sponsors.
Number 3, Rachel Abella.
Tournament All-Star and silver medalist this year, Rachel Abella.
Number 4, Caitlin
Arbor. Caitlin Arbor there, she had some good minutes tonight.
Number 5, Allison De
La Renzi. De La Renzi there, she really had an underrated game here today.
Number 11,
really led the charge back in the fourth quarter. course, we remember Jenna Bella going down earlier in the game here to come back in the second half play is quite good.
That's right, Jay. She made a great recovery.
Brown there got into foul trouble early, but a great player. Really led them in their semifinal victory. Portia Hewitt played sparingly the last two games. And same with Boric. Steph there, what a tournament for her. She really earned that silver medal this weekend.
Steph Rymack, a standout at Mohawk.
Carissa Brown, one of the leaders. She brought Mohawk to the semifinal there, but got into some foul trouble early in the final and didn't have as big of an impact as we would have wanted. That's Natalie Fisher there.
Number 32, Lacey Walters. Lacey Walters, great addition to the Falcons.
Player of the game in this final for Mohawk. Jessica Grant there. Played a few minutes tonight, had a pretty good game.
Number 34, Michaela
Matumbo. I think she was injured in this tournament, but well-deserved medal as well. She was, of course, part of the team.
Yeah, she was a healthy scratch the last two games. She'll be a welcome addition.
Number 42, Lisa Goldring.
Goldring had some quality minutes tonight.
Number 44,
Jaquela Dose. Yeah, Jaquela Dose stepped up. She got some minutes when the Brown sisters went down tonight, but she stepped up and played well. Now we're into the coaching staff and trainers here.
Assistant coach Allison Curry.
You know, the one thing here, the players put in the practice hours, but it's the coaches that prepare. Not only the practice hours and the game hours, but the several hours behind the scenes preparing and scouting and everything else and making sure the team is prepared. And for a fifth-year coach, Kevin Duffy here, and they've really set him up well for the future here at Mohawk.
Absolutely.
With his son there. Two officials here from the OCAA to hand out the gold medals, championship t-shirts, and hats.
That's some nice looking OCAA gear.
Gabrielle Moya there.
Number five, Amber Burton.
Amber Burton, she didn't play long in this game here, but she had an impact when she did, about 15 minutes or so.
Cupid, the standout in the tournament. One of my favorites.
Tournament MVP had just a fantastic weekend. Mazzarelli there, she really played well and backup point guard there to Cupid. Real successor next year. Abbott, she's great on defense right there. Really played well on D and stopped some Mohawk players.
I have to agree.
Lauren Carey there, I think we didn't really call her name too much, but a good role player there. She got some steals coming in. And just right of there on the tournament all-star team.
Number 11, Sarah Ferguson.
Sarah Ferguson, another great role player here on this Thunder team.
Number 14, Lindsay Whitaker.
Lindsay Whitaker, but she had an impact in that second half, right when the Thunder needed it to pull away.
Number 22, Sierra Churchill.
Churchill sat out this weekend here. We'll see her in the future, I'm sure. Now, Basquin, real defensive impact. She's a factor in that post there.
Great athletic player.
Lansbury coming up there.
Lansbury made her mark at the end of the game today.
And for a freshman, too, on a senior team.
Absolutely.
And Sandra Basco stepping in. Yeah, a fantastic game, player of the game for Algonquin. Now we're into the coaching staff here.
Assistant coach Anna Sutley Brazley. Associate head coach Laura Fawn.
And Now, for the fourth time in 9 years, John McGinnis is an OCAA champion and off to the Nationals.
He definitely knows what he's doing. All right, folks. Well, that's it for the OCAA 2014 Women's Basketball Championship. You just witnessed the gold game being played against Algonquin and Mohawk. Algonquin came out with the victory and won the gold. And it was played here at the David Brayley Athletic Center. Big thanks to the television broadcasting department here at Mohawk for bringing this broadcast to you. I'm signing off. Elvin Drent along here with Jake Parkhill. Thanks for watching, and have a great evening.